blood in it. She was starting to see. She was 8 months old. 8 months old. You know, and I had no idea that her intestines were bleeding out or her brain was swelling, and that this tremors that I thought was because her fever was going high was actually seizures, grandma's seizures. And I remember driving to the hospital because I didn't think the ambulance would make it in time. And I probably should call the ambulance, but I made it there. And I cut in line, and like a mad woman, I really was like a mad woman because I thought this was it. And I said, this can't wait. And she was starting to seize in my arms. And the nurse looked. She was, usually they have a different attendant, but it was a nurse watching the front desk. And she took me back to triage. And, you know, this is painful to talk about. This is not easy. This is not easy. We go back to triage, and they're undressing her. And suddenly there's two more nurses, and they decide to move her to a gurney, like in a little fabric hospital room, you know, where they had the curtain that comes around. And next thing I know, there's a doctor here, and they're asking assistant questions, what has been going on today, you know, because they want to know the history. And she was normal that morning, babbling. She threw her green beans. They were mushed, of course. And that she was normal, and that we got her vaccinations at 3. And I'm so glad we did. What would have happened if we hadn't gotten them? And then next thing I know, there's carts being rushed, and I'm physically being pushed back as I watch them work on my infant daughter. And as I said before, she had 4 shots containing 9 vaccines. One of the vaccines was the DTaP. It is now considered that's the one that caused most of the damage in my child. And they're taking her diaper off, and there's blood in the diaper, and she's seizing, and they're trying to start an IV, and there's oxygen, and because my daughter, she can't breathe. She's not getting enough oxygen. And I did not know it at the time. Her brain is swelling, all from a vaccine. You know, if you're getting ready to go to a well baby child check, you know, or you're scheduling it, please educate yourself before you vaccinate. Do not walk in my shoes every single day, especially in the early years. I said more than once, I wish somebody had told me. So I'm telling you now that there are toxins in the vaccines, that certain children should not get vaccines. You can get a titer test, T-I-T-E-R, titer. You can get that from your doctor. It's less than $20. And it can show if they have the titers in their systems, if they're already immune. All these things, they matter. They matter so much. So I'm going to play a song for the people that are tweeting the hashtag CDC whistleblower. Oh, and oh, by the way, I couldn't sue the vaccine manufacturer because of the damage done to my child. My government, your government, took that right away. Don't forget that. They are taking rights away. And it's time that you opened your eyes, take notice, call your congressman, act appropriately. And tweeters, please tweet CDC, hashtag CDC whistleblower. We can do this. We can reach 1 billion impressions by January 1st if we try hard. Please remember to retweet other people. That helps with our impressions. Retweet, even if you don't like that person, even if you don't like the way their hair is or how they talk, who cares? At this point, it is the movement that matters. Hashtag CDC whistleblower. This is from the Noisettes. Don't give up.
Sometimes they'll want to cut you down, gotta scratch that itch, cause the time is now. They tell you that you gotta have a heart of steel. If you want to keep up, can you afford to feel? Run the system wrong, gotta tear it down, let it fall to the seabed like a rusty crown. Through the stars, love the moonbeams glare, shackles on your feet gotta disappear. What if I tried to tell you to do it more? Can't you see, baby, life's knocking right at your door? to go. She said, ooh, I just don't know for sure. What if I tried to tell you to do it? Oh, don't give up, don't give up.
And that was the Noisettes calling for don't give up. And I'm telling you, don't give up. We can do this. Remember, remember, retweet causes more impressions. Please retweet. It is so important. It's just a simple click. Find a friend that's tweeting the CDC whistleblower hashtag and go to their page and go down their page. Find the tweets that you want to retweet and then go to the next one. You can go to the hashtag CDC whistleblower timeline and go down the list. Maybe there's some people you don't know. If they have a link, check the link out before you retweet it. It's very important. Or an incomplete tweet. An incomplete tweet can cause problems with the CDC whistleblower hashtag. So I need you to remember that. So I do have a chat room. You can log in to this, or if you're just listening to it on your Twitter page, you can keep it on your Twitter page, open a new link on a new tab and go to Twitter. You can listen to this as you're tweeting. I'm doing this to inspire you, to remind you to keep going, that we're in this together on this platform, on this podcast. I cannot accept calls unless I do it through Skype. If you want to, we can do that. But I'm going to be tweeting and playing clips and encouraging you to retweet and tweet hashtag CDC whistleblower. If you're in the chat room, you have no idea what I'm talking about, just let me know and I'll be happy to explain it. We're going to go back in time. We're going to take the trolley, the Mr. Rogers trolley. And we're going to go back in time and talk about that. But before I do that, let's look up. It's a Josh Groban song, and it's called You Are Loved, and it's a very much a don't give up type of song. I want to play that. All right. Let's listen, and we'll talk more later. Get to tweeting, ladies and gentlemen.
Be alive, don't It's just the hurt that you hide when you're lost inside. I'll be there to find you. Don't give up because you want to burn bright. If darkness blinds you, I will shine to guide you. Everybody wants to be understood. Well, I can't hear you. Everybody wants to be loved. Don't give up because you
Thank you. That was Your Love by Josh Groban. Playing these things to keep you motivated, to keep you inspired, to keep tweeting, hashtag CDC Whistleblower. Now, I have a clip from Mayor Einstein. He has a show that he co-hosts with an attorney, Alan. Oh, gosh. I apologize. But it's called Know Your Rights. So if you want to find that show, it's called Know Your Rights. It's on Blog Talk Radio. There's a lot of archive listens that you can listen to. I think Marcella Piper Terry's been on there. Dr. Sherry Tenpenny's been on there. So many people. And they have a show, I think, twice a week, sometimes more, depending on the time and what is happening. But this is Mayor talking about how the flu vaccines are risky, and I like what he has to say. Let's take a listen.
Hi, this is Dr. Mayor Einstein. I reported before, it's not too late to not get the flu shot. And an outstanding review in Vaccine Risk Awareness Network, brand www.vran.org, and I'll post the link and the site here, talked about the flu shot. Influenza is not very common. They talk about the flu shots are ineffective, and they list study after study about the ineffectiveness of the flu vaccine. Flu shots are risky, and they talk about the study after study about the risk of the flu vaccine. You know, it's almost hard to understand why the U.S. government and the rest of the world has gone so nuts over the so-called, quote, need for a flu vaccine. Flu vaccine.